Chill, as I like to call you. Michael from Red Chair Diaries. 20 after 5. Friday, the 27th of July, I think. And here I am. I'm still in my bathrobe. I mean, it's... I have a day off. It's been raining a lot. I've got a cat on the bed. I've got a dog next to the bed. I took a nap after I took Ted to work. I pick him up at 6 o'clock. I'm having a lazy fucking day, and it's marvelous, and I've just trying to watch some YouTubes and see people's reviews of The Dark Knight Rises, which I wouldn't watch until after I saw the movie and did mine. Just crazy. Anyway, oh my God, there I go again. That sleep apnea and those meds don't do many favors. Anyway, book collecting. Good subject. As the older fellow here, my collecting goes back quite far. I got my first video recorder when they were still quite new. So I got it, I guess, August or September of 1981, because I bought it to celebrate the fact that I got a new job then that actually paid enough to live on and make purchases. And that was when I started working at BCIT. So I bought not Sony. My God, what brand was it? Because it was VHS. Oh my God, I wonder if it was Panasonic. Because Sony was Betamax. Isn't it funny? I don't remember that. Anyway, I bought that at the Hudson's Bay Company. And it was an outgoing model. And it was still, I think, $1,400. And it had the cord, because they weren't wireless then, and you had to tune your channels into that video recorder. There's all kinds of buttons where you had to tune them in, like 15 channels you had, or channel 1 to 13 or something, I don't even remember. Oh my God! Oh, good thing we're going out for dinner to one of the pubs, so I could stay awake maybe. So it was mostly watching recording TV shows, and I'm trying to think, what was the first movie I had? I remember the first, I've told this story probably 6 times, the first blank tape I bought was $28. That's the first blank tape. So, you know, people have no idea what we used to pay for things. $28, and I had, you know, 2-hour VHS tape, so I could record some shows. And then they went through price drops after that. But, oh dear, and it was so hard to buy a movie because they cost so much. So I didn't start my real collecting, because you had to go to the video store and rent the movies, until the price drops started. And price drops on VHS tapes really started around the time of Top Gun, when that came out and Paramount decided, I think it was Paramount, to go for sell-through as opposed to rental revenue. And I think that was $30 or $40 for that. I don't think I bought it. I don't think I ever had a copy. I think I rented it. Oh my God, I'm going to die here. Oh. And I was excited when Paramount started putting out their Star Trek catalog, their Star Trek movies, in the VHS. And remember, Star Trek 1 came out in 1979, December. I think it was my birthday, December 11th. And then Star Trek 2 came out the summer of 82. Star Trek 3, 1984. Star Trek 4, 1986. And by that point, you know, sell-through was established to be able to purchase VHS. But I remember maybe it was 84, 85, or 86, and Paramount had put out some kind of anniversary collections of the first two or three Star Trek movies, and also Raiders of the Lost Ark, and then Columbia, I guess it was, or MGM, or somebody was starting to put out the Bond movies. And so that's the time. It's the first half of the 1980s when I started accumulating a lot of VHS tapes. And you know, I gave the fucking things away when I moved from out west. I just couldn't carry those hundreds of tapes. And now I see everybody still collecting them. So, like, you know, I brought more shit here and I didn't have enough sense to bring those, right? And then we collected laser discs because we were not only the first people, or the second person I knew was me, to have a private VHS player. But we were, I think, the first people we knew to get a laser disc player. And we were the first people that Ted and I knew to get hi-fi stereo VHS players when they came out, because the first ones were mono, okay? Or at least stereo. They might have been stereo, but they weren't hi-fi. And hi-fi was a big step forward. I mean, that had its own logo on the boxes. And then we were the first ones we knew to buy a DVD player. I think it was $700. And now they're like 7 cents. And whenever those came out, I know that we were also the first ones that we knew to have a CD player in 1984 when they came out, and that was $800. So people don't understand that what $800 was 20 years ago, or 30 years ago, basically, is thousands and thousands of dollars now. And now we bulk at, if you see a television that's 40-inch HD, you go, $600? $700? Too much money, you know? Like, the buying power has increased exponentially. And then we get ruined about it. Because when I bought my first Batman Laserdisc, my only Batman Laserdisc of the 1989 movie, I bought it in 1990 when we were on a business trip to Chicago. Both of us, Ted and I both went. That was $100 or more. It might have even been more. I think, you know, at least with taxes, it was definitely more to buy that Tim Burton Batman movie when it came out in laser. Panned and scanned, I believe. I mean, I still have it, but I don't think it's wise. So my collecting has been very eclectic since the early 80s. And I'm not collecting as fervently as most of you. You know, I mean, Ted and I had several DVDs before I ever did my first YouTube 2 years ago. But we stopped for a long time, for a long, long time. And I'm only buying them now to keep up with some of you. So, you know, we could, at least we can see them in widescreen now on a widescreen TV. When we were buying DVDs that had widescreen options, you were watching them on a 4x3 TV. So we go back a long time with our collecting. Can also tell you my first record I ever bought. I was a child. I have never seen the movie Peter Pan, the Walt Disney cartoon, but I remember my first 45 was a yellow version of Never Smile at a Crocodile. And I remember that as clearly as if it was yesterday. And I'd go around in my toneless voice singing Never Smile at a Crocodile. And I think the first long-playing album I ever bought was, I think it was the Mamas and Papas Deliver, 1967 or 68. So, been buying stuff. I'm a consumer of the first order. I mean, I have, I think at last count, I think I own 7 computers. And I've got 2 video cameras. I mean, tablet. I've got three high definition televisions. Two of them are 720. One's in the closet in my bedroom, the big rear projection Sony LCD, because the bulb has gotten dim and we can't be bothered replacing it for a second time. And then I've got a 720 cheap Future Shop Insignia behind the computer here. And then I've got the nice Sony in the living room for the Blu-rays. We collect. We had lots of stuff over the years, and I'm really going on and on and on. I'm sorry. I might have fallen asleep and just talked automatically here. Anyway, I think your contest is overly generous. I can't believe that you're buying all this stuff. But you're putting it on offer. I certainly will. I want to be entered. I don't know if I want everything or that, but maybe if there's something, if I should win something, if I come up in the draw, then we could figure out if I want us to go back in the pool or not, because some of the stuff I have, so. And something else I want to talk to you about at some point, if you're either on Skype or Facebook or whatever, give me a shout, because I would like to do, I think I'd like to do some kind of contest in the future. Like, let's go in and do something together and get some excitement instead of just doing individual contests. Maybe we there were so many, and now there's several this month too, that maybe people should start amalgamating and having some contests, like cross-pollinate, the subscription list and things like that. And I think that could be very interesting. I just think that we need some more creativity with some of the options out there. Anyway, it's Michael, who is always sleepy, Red Chair Diaries, Nova Scotia, Canada. And Scott, a wonderful contest, and thanks for inviting me to it. And I enjoy your stuff, and I want you to go back to sitting in your big wicker chair there. I just love the visual of you sitting in that chair. I just think it's great. Okay, see you around the tube, guy. Bye, bye, guy, guys.